Today we will start a new topic, which is the pressure. First, the definition of the pressure. So how we define a pressure? Pressure is simply how much force is acting on a specific area. So example, this is a surface and which is having area of 2 meters square. And we apply a force of 200 newtons. But what is the concept of a pressure? Pressure means how much force is acting on 1 meter square area. So force on 1 meter square area, that is called pressure. So force is 200 and area is 2 meter square, but we need a force which is acting on 1 meter square. So how we get that? The force divided by area. So 200 divided by 2, what we get? We get 100 Newton per meter square. What does it mean, Newton per meter square? It shows 100 Newton force is acting on 1 meter square area. So a simple definition of the pressure. Pressure is simply the force which act on unit area, and the force should be right angle to the surface or 90 degree to the surface. Whenever we are calculating a pressure, the force should be perpendicular or 90 degree. You can see here the angle between the force and the surface is 90 degrees. So pressure is a force acting on unit area at right angle to the surface. These are some examples of pressure, like pushing the wall or cutting carrot here or vegetable. How to calculate a pressure? Pressure can be calculated by force divided by area. And the unit of the pressure, is, because the unit of force is Newton and unit of area is meter square. So unit of pressure is Newton per meter square. And this Newton per meter square is also known as, it's named after a physicist, so that's also known as Pascal. So Newton per meter square or Pascal having a same meaning. So if I say pressure is 20 Newton per meter square, what I can say, I can also say pressure is equals to 20 Pascal. An SI unit of pressure is Pascal or Newton per meter square. Other unit can be kilopascal or megapascal. Kilopascal means if I say pressure is 1 kPa, 1 kilopascal, so it means it is 1000 Pascal. And if I say it's 1 megapascal, it means 1 million Pascal. Is it clear, the concept of the pressure? The force which we apply on a specific area, we call that as pressure. Same thing, a force is applied on a specific area, what we call that as pressure. Is it clear, the concept of pressure? And to calculate this, it's force divided by area. So example question, if you want to calculate pressure, the base for a statue rest on a level ground is made from a stone and is 2 meter long and 2.5 meter high and 0.8 meter wide. The weight is 96,000. Calculate the pressure. But to calculate the pressure, we need force. What is the force here? The weight of an object is a force. So 96,000 is a force which is acting downward. Basically, it's a weight, and weight is a force, and it is acting down. So that's 96,000. Divided by area. So what area I will take? I will take the base area, because the force should be perpendicular or 90 degree. So what is the base area here? In this case, the base area will be 0.8 multiplied by 2. So to calculate the area, it's 0.8 multiplied by 2 or 2.0, which is equals to 1.6 meters square. So area is 1.6 meters square and the force is 96,000 Newton. We want to calculate a pressure. The formula for pressure, it's force divided by area. So the final answer is 240,000 or 15,000. Force divided by area, so 96,000 divided by 1.6.
60,000.
Because we always take the base area, as I mentioned in the beginning, the definition is force. Force should be perpendicular. So force is acting downward. The weight is acting downward. So base area, this one is a base area. So we took the base area to calculate the pressure. So you will remember this from a triangle. The formula for a pressure. So pressure, force, area. So if we need a pressure, then it is force divided by area. If we need a force, then pressure multiplied by area. And if we need area, then it is force divided by pressure. Is it clear, the concept of the pressure? So in this example, four physics teachers investigate pressure. They wear identical clothes and lie on a different beds of nail. The table gives a weight. The table gives the weight of each teacher and the total area contact between the teacher and the nail. Which teacher experienced the least pressure? So how you can identify the least pressure? So what you have to do? The weight of the teacher is actually the force which is acting, and area is given. Here area is centimeter square, so final answer will be Newton per centimeter square. But you cannot say Pascal because Newton per centimeter square is not equivalent to Pascal. So you will just say Newton per centimeter square. So how to calculate the pressure for each? This will be 700 divided by 13. 800 divided by 20, 900 divided by 14, and 1000 divided by 21, which is having the smallest value. Which ratio is the smallest? So 800 divided by 20. Which is the smallest ratio here? So B is the right answer. In this example, figure 3.1 shows an oil tank that has a rectangular base and the dimension are 2.4 by 1.5. So 2.4 by 1.5 multiplied by 1.5 total volume will be there. The tank is filled with the oil of density 850 kilogram per meter cube. And depth 1.5 meter. Calculate the pressure exerted by the oil. There is a formula to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid, but we can also use the other method. Which method we can use to calculate a pressure? Pressure is force divided by area. So first, what we need to calculate a pressure, we need a force or we need a weight. And second thing, what we need an area. Area we can all identify because it's 2.4 multiplied by 1.5. So 2.4 multiplied by 1.5, we can simply get the area. But how to get the force? So it's 2.4 times 1.5, that's equal to 3.6 meter square. How to get the force? Force is actually the weight of the oil which is acting downward. How we can find that weight? As we know, weight is equals to mass multiplied by gravity. How to find the mass of this? We have the density, we have length, width, and height. So the mass is equals to density multiplied by volume. So mass is equals to density. So density is how much? It's 850 multiplied by volume. What is the volume? 2.4 multiplied by 1.5 multiplied by 1.5. So 2.4 multiplied 1.5 multiplied 1.5 multiplied 850, we will get the mass. So it is 850 multiplied by 2.4 multiplied 1.5 multiplied 1.5. So answer is 4,590. So mass is equals to 4,590 kilogram. But we need a weight. So how to find the weight? Weight is mass multiplied by gravity. So 4,590 multiplied by gravity, which is 10. So you will get 45,900 Newton. 4,590 was a mass, but you multiplied by gravity, you will get the weight, which is 45,900. Now to calculate a pressure, pressure is force divided by area. So force is equals to 45,900 and the area, the base area is given 3.6. So the pressure exerted is equals to 12,750 Pascal. So first what we did, we calculate the area, which is length into width, the base area, and then we calculate the weight of the oil. How to calculate weight of the oil? The density was given, the volume was given, density multiplied by volume, we got the mass, and mass multiplied by gravity, we got the weight. And weight divided by area, or force divided by area, we calculated the pressure. But there is also another method to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid. This is a long method in which you have to use many formulas. Pascal is a unit of pressure. Like unit of time is second, unit of temperature is degree centigrade or Kelvin, unit of length is meter. So unit of pressure is Pascal, or you can say Newton per meter square. So pressure depends on two things. Number one, it depends on how much force we are applying. The higher force, the greater pressure. Example, you have two identical objects. Same size object, but made up of a different material. This object weight is 30 Newton. Object B weight is 60 Newton. Which object will exert greater force or greater pressure when they are left or kept on the surface, horizontal surface? Which object is exerting greater pressure? So B is exerting greater pressure, or pressure exerted by the B is more than pressure exerted by A. So basically, the pressure depends on how much force we apply. If you apply a greater force or a higher force, then the pressure will also increase. And you can identify from the formula, pressure is force divided by area. So you can see if we increase the force, because force and pressure both are in numerator, so they are directly proportional. Increasing the force will increase the pressure applied on the object. The second factor, it depends on the base area or the surface area. So if you have two objects, but same mass or same weight, but different base areas, which object will apply greater pressure? If both have the same weights. This is 30 Newton. This one is also 30 Newton. Which one exert greater pressure on the surface? So B will apply greater pressure, because you can see here less area, and you can identify from the formula. You can identify from formula, pressure is force divided by area. If you use a less base area, smaller base area, then the pressure exerted or experienced will be more. So two factors on which the pressure depends. Yes?
I don't understand.
Which part? The first or the second? Base area?
Yes, the base area, the first part.
Okay. Look, pressure applied on the object, pressure exerted by the object depends on two factors. Because as we know, the formula for pressure, pressure is force divided by area. So if we have two objects of same areas, then the one which is having greater force or applying greater force will exert more pressure. So if I use the values, example, you have two objects having the same base area. Area of the first object is 2 meters square. Area of the second object is also 2 meters square. The weight of the first object is 200 Newton. And weight of the second object is, say, 400 Newtons. So without, I can calculate the pressure, or without calculating a pressure, I can also identify which one exert greater pressure and which one exert least or lower pressure. If two objects have the same base areas, if area is same, the relation between pressure and force, they are directly proportional. Means the object which is having or exerting a greater force will apply more pressure. So if I calculate a pressure, pressure is force acting on unit area. So if I calculate the pressure exerted by A, the force is 200 and the area is 2 meters square. So 200 divided by 2, the pressure will be 100 Pascal. When I calculate the pressure exerted by B, so pressure is force on unit area, the force is 400 and the base area is same too. So 400 divided by 2, which is equals to 200 Pascal. So with calculation also, you can see the one, if two objects have the same base areas or two objects have the same areas, then the object which is heavier or the object which is having greater weight or force will apply more pressure. So B will exert greater pressure. And A will apply small pressure or less pressure on the surface or on the ground. Is it clear, the first part?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
And the second part is, it depends on the area as well. Like if you have objects, but different areas, and they have the same weights. So if I say this object is 30 Newton, the other object is also 30 Newton. The base area or area of this object, the first object, example 2 meters square. And area of the second object, example 4 meters square. So if I want to find a relation between pressure and area, as we know, pressure is force divided by area. So if two objects are applying the same force, then instead of calculation, I can just use the concept or the theory that object which is having a small base area will apply more pressure or greater pressure. So when I calculate the pressure, pressure is force divided by area. So force is equals to 30. And what is area? Area is 2 here. So 30 divided by 2, it's equal to 15 pascal. But when I calculate the pressure exerted by the second object, the force is 30, but the base area is 4. So 30 divided by 4, that's equal to 7.5 pascal. So with calculation, you can find as well, or without calculation, if the object is having a small base area, if two objects exerting a same force, the one which is having a smaller base area will apply more pressure on the surface. Is it clear? The second part?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
So pressure which we apply depend on how much force is applied and what is the base area. So example, we can increase, it means we can change the pressure, we can increase the pressure and we can decrease the pressure as well. So how we can, for example, if we want to increase the pressure, we should reduce the area. That's why, like sharp knives or pins, why it is useful? Because what happened, these knives, the sharp knife is having a small area. So when it is having a small area, it can easily pierce or can cut the vegetable or the fruit or the object. So area under the edge of the knife blade is very small. So when the area is small, as we know the formula for pressure, pressure is force acting on unit area. So if area is small, it will apply more pressure, or as it will apply more pressure, it will be easy to cut the object or the material. Same way, we can also decrease the pressure. How we can decrease the pressure? Another example, like a thumb pin or a pin. So you can see here, it is sharp. So as it is sharp, the area is small. If area is small, this side will apply more pressure. If I apply a force of 60 Newton on the pin, how much force is applied by the pin on the surface? So it will also apply the same force, which is 60 Newton. Force will be same in both cases. If I apply a force of 60 Newton, the pin, the sharp edge of a pin will also, the sharp end of a pin will also apply the same force, but because this is having a small area, so pressure is force by area. So smaller base area exert more pressure, as it can exert more pressure. So we can easily attach object to the pin. Is it clear? The concept of increasing pressure by reducing the area. Same thing, we can also do opposite. If you want to decrease the pressure, what we should do? We should increase the area. So reducing pressure by increasing areas. So what happened? Because the snow is a, this is a soft ground. So if it's a soft ground, if more pressure is there, then likely the object will sink. So to reduce the effect or to reduce the pressure, what we do, we increase the area. So as we increase the area, the pressure on the snow or the soft ground will decrease. So less likely the object will sink. Same thing, these tractors moving on the field or the soft ground. So why these tractors having a very large wheels? What is the reason for that to have these very large wheels? Because what happened as the ground is soft and the weight of the tractor is too much, so the tractor likely to create holes on the ground. So to reduce this effect, what we do, we use a large area. If we use a large area, then the pressure on the ground will be less or small. So this is the example. By increasing the area, we can reduce the pressure. So pressure can be increased or decreased by changing the base area as well. Any doubt in this? Yes.
Sir, can you explain any other example of this topic by increasing the area?
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, in this example, a man is standing on the ground. Which action will increase the pressure that the man exert on the ground? What do you think? What could be the answer? The man slowly bend his knee. The man slowly lies down on the ground. The man slowly raise his arm, or man slowly raise one foot off the ground. We want to increase the pressure. So what we should do? Because as the man will slowly raise one foot, so as he raises one foot, the area, the base area or the contact area will decrease. As the area will decrease, the pressure exerted on the ground will be higher or it will increase. So D was the right answer. Which situation is an example of force acting over a large area to produce a small pressure? So force acting on unit area to create a small pressure. In which case the pressure will be smaller? A builder hammering a nail into a piece of wood. So as a builder is hammering a nail into a piece of wood, so area of the nail is small. If area of nail is small, the pressure exerted by the nail will be higher. So that's not the answer, because this is for high pressure, but the question they are asking for low pressure. A cook using a sharp knife to cut the vegetables. Again, a sharp knife, so smaller area, so exert more pressure. A nurse pushing a needle into a patient's arm. Again, smaller area, so more pressure. A soldier marching in a flat-soled boot. So in a flat-soled boot, it will have greater area. So as it will have greater area, the force will be, the pressure will be smaller. That's why D is the right answer. Answer which shows that the pressure is reduced. then the pressure exerted by the liquids. How the pressure is exerted by the liquid? Liquid exert pressure in all the direction, because what happened if you have a container which is filled with the liquid? These are the particles of the liquid. The liquid particles are moving around each other. So these liquid particles, because they are not moving, they are also moving randomly. So as they collide with the surface or each other, so as these particles colliding with each other or with any object which is inside the liquid, what they will do? They will create a pressure. So whenever object is there inside a liquid, the liquid particles are moving and colliding with the surface. As the liquid particles are moving and colliding with the surface, these particles of a liquid apply force on a unit area, which create a pressure. How to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid? The formula to calculate this pressure. Actually, it's the same formula. The formula, what is the formula for pressure? Pressure formula is force divided by area. So example, if you have a container which is filled with the liquid, and you want to find the pressure exerted by the liquid on the base of this container. So weight of the liquid is acting downward. The area, the base area for this container, so the base area of this container is A. So if you want to calculate the pressure, we can simply write the weight of the liquid divided by area will get the pressure. But how to get the weight of the liquid? As we know, weight is mass multiplied by gravity. So in place of weight, I can write mass multiplied by gravity. So mass multiplied by gravity divided by area. So pressure is force acting on unit area, or the weight which is acting on a unit area, that's also pressure for the liquid. Weight is equals to mg. So mass multiplied by gravity divided by area, you will get the pressure. And what is mass in terms of density? Density multiplied by volume. When density is multiplied by volume, you will get the mass of an object. And what is volume of the object? Volume of the object is equals to area multiplied by height. So density is equals to volume multiplied by gravity divided by area. And what is volume? Volume is area multiplied by height into gravity divided by area. So this area will cancel with area. So what you are left with, you are left with last formula, that pressure exerted by the liquid is equals to density of the liquid, the depth of the liquid, and the gravity. You don't have to G is for the gravity. So you don't have to learn, you don't have to learn this derivation. The last formula is important. That pressure exerted by the liquid is equals to density multiplied by depth multiplied by gravity. So I'll repeat, look, the how this formula came. As we know, pressure is force divided by area. What is a force? The force is weight of an object divided by area. What is weight of an object? Weight is equals to mass multiplied by gravity divided by area. And what is mass? Mass is density multiplied by volume. So in place of mass, I can write density into volume into gravity divided by area. And what is volume? Volume is area multiplied by height or area multiplied by length. So pressure exerted is equals to density multiplied area multiplied depth multiplied gravity divided by area. Area will cancel with area. So what you are left with? Pressure exerted by the liquid depends on the density of the liquid, depends on the height or the depth of the liquid, and depends on the gravity. So this is a formula which we use to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid. You don't have to bother about this derivation. This derivation is not important. This is just an idea that how it came. But the final formula is important, that whenever you have a liquid and you want to calculate a pressure exerted by the liquid, the density of the liquid multiplied by gravity multiplied by height. And volume is equals to area multiplied by height. So the same question, in the previous example, I solved this question. First, I got the weight, then I calculated the area, and then I calculated the pressure. But without this area, I can also use the same concept if I want to find the pressure exerted by the liquid. So pressure exerted by the liquid is equals to density of the liquid multiplied by gravity of the liquid multiplied by depth. So density of the liquid was how much? It's 850 multiplied by gravity, because it's on Earth, so gravity is 10, multiplied by depth. So what is the depth of the liquid? It's 1.5. So I'll multiply 1.5. So 850 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 1.5. What's the answer? So this will be same answer as we calculated. It will be 12,750 Pascal. So first I solve this question by using a formula, pressure by area, and then I use a simple concept of density into gravity into depth, I will get the same result. That's why whenever we want to find pressure exerted by the liquid, we use the formula density, gravity, and depth instead of using a long method. Gravity, you have to always consider as 10. I told you, whenever you are using a formula, the gravity value is always 10. So whenever you are calculating a pressure by the liquid apply pressure in all the direction. But if you want to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid, it's the density of the liquid multiplied by gravity and multiplied by depth. This is a simple formula to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquids. If you want to compare the pressure exerted by the liquids, like different liquids,